The promise was bold. Zero emission cars powered by hydrogen, refueling as fast as a traditional gas vehicle. Toyota's Mirai hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicle, for example, was backed by the company's hopes, aiming to transform passenger transportation. But for early adopters, the hydrogen dream has turned into somewhat of a nightmare. Vehicle resale values have fallen drastically. Poor fuel economy and ongoing challenges with finding stations to fuel these vehicles. Was the Toyota Mirai an epic failure, case of broken promises, or a sign that hydrogen just isn't ready for passenger cars? Toyota seems overwhelmed, with the company and its dealers facing lawsuits varying from lemon law violations, fraud, and broken promises of an ownership experience equivalent to that of gas cars. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. It has a high energy content per unit of mass compared to traditional fuels like gasoline. This translates to potential for longer driving ranges with smaller fuel storage in applications like transportation. Unlike a battery-powered car, hydrogen vehicles use fuel cells. Think of it like a tiny power plant on board a vehicle. The fuel cell combines hydrogen with oxygen from the air, generating electricity to drive the vehicle. The only emissions? Water vapor. On paper, the advantages of hydrogen fuel cell technology are clear: zero harmful emissions while driving, potential for fast refueling like a gasoline car, and the ability to travel longer distances than many battery electric vehicles. That's why automakers saw the promise and why governments around the world have invested in the idea. But turning that promise into reality, well, that's where things get complicated. Toyota isn't alone with Mirai. Competitors like Hyundai and BMW also face the same major uphill battle. They're refining the technology, searching for solutions, but the question remains: can hydrogen passenger cars ever truly be viable? But there are glimmers of hope for hydrogen cars. Toyota hasn't entirely thrown in the towel on hydrogen cars. The company is experimenting with smaller, saddle-shaped hydrogen tanks designed to mimic electric car batteries, potentially allowing for the technology to fit in a wider range of models. Then there is German automaker BMW with its iX5 hydrogen SUV, which is currently undergoing extensive testing with over 100 examples of the model deployed around the world. This pilot is putting the vehicle through its paces in a variety of conditions, including extreme temperatures and challenging terrain. And guess what? The results are promising. The iX5's fuel cell system, hydrogen tanks, and electric motor performed well, even in harsh conditions. This showcases the potential for hydrogen cars to be not just environmentally friendly, but also very capable and reliable daily drivers. South Korean automaker Hyundai, currently the world's number one hydrogen car maker with roughly 38% market share, is doubling down on hydrogen as an alternative fuel. The company is aiming to be a hydrogen powerhouse, controlling the entire supply chain from production to storage. It's a risky move, but potentially one that could pay off big for the company. Honda, the Japanese automaker, is taking a cautious step back into the hydrogen game following the discontinuation of its Clarity fuel cell electric vehicle in 2017. At that time, Honda was one of the only companies to sell a hydrogen-powered vehicle. They're now back with their 2025 CR-V-E FCEV. This fuel cell SUV boasts a 270-mile driving range, including nearly 30 miles of all-electric driving range, which is a clear nod to hybrid technology given its popularity. Interestingly, the fuel cells for this project are coming from Honda's partnership with General Motors. Is this potentially a hint for more collaboration between the two companies? Across the board, automakers are seeing a better fit for hydrogen in commercial vehicles. And why is that? Well, trucks and buses often run predictable routes and return to the same depots, where dedicated hydrogen stations make refueling more practical. Add in the need for quick refueling and suddenly hydrogen starts to make sense. But as much as there are several advantages to hydrogen, it comes with several drawbacks. Producing hydrogen is expensive and often not very green. Most production methods still rely on fossil fuels, releasing the same pollutants into the atmosphere that we're trying to reduce with the transition to cleaner forms of transportation. There are also some key safety considerations for hydrogen. Hydrogen gas is highly flammable, with a wider flammability than gasoline. A hydrogen leak near an ignition source, say for example an electrical spark, could result in a fire or explosion. While the future prospects for hydrogen in passenger vehicles looks dim, there's encouraging news from the commercial vehicle sector. Toyota's been testing hydrogen-powered semis at the port of Long Beach in California for the past several years, accumulating an impressive amount of mileage on hydrogen-powered vehicles. And up in the Arctic Circle, Volvo Trucks has been testing in sub-zero temperatures to prove that their fuel cells can handle extreme conditions. The company is targeting the second half of this decade for commercial production of a hydrogen semi. Meanwhile, Nikola Trucks claims they've actually delivered around 40 hydrogen trucks to customers year to date in 2024. Ford and General Motors, the American automakers, are engaged in several partnerships with the aim of developing hydrogen-powered vehicles. While the fate of hydrogen-powered passenger cars hangs in the balance, its potential in the commercial segment is undeniable. Long-haul trucking, buses, and other types of commercial vehicles, these applications benefit from the fast refueling hydrogen offers, offsetting its current infrastructure challenges. But what about battery-powered commercial trucks and buses? Well, hydrogen still offers a potential clear advantage over battery-powered vehicles. Given the enormous battery packs that buses and trucks require, as well as the electric infrastructure that commercial operations require to keep these vehicles going, as well as the charging time involved, hydrogen-powered vehicles are lighter and are quicker to refuel. Could the success of hydrogen in the commercial vehicle segment pave the way for its broader use? If technology evolves to make hydrogen production greener and storage more compact, then perhaps the long-promised future of hydrogen passenger cars might finally arrive. But for now, it seems that trucks and buses will pave the way forward with hydrogen, potentially creating a path for hydrogen-powered passenger vehicles in the not-so-distant future. As always, thanks for watching this video. For more from the definitive source for clean tech, e-mobility, and sustainability, make sure that you like and that you're subscribed to cleanearth.io.